Hello again, here we go. Got my transmission jack. That's the one I've been talking about, telling you I'd do the update on. It's a $129 Harbor Freight special, but as long as it works, that's all I care about. Let's see there, 800 pound, 24 and a half inch. Max height, 8.5 inch minimum height, and got a 48 inch safety chain, which goes right there. I've never really used the chains. I've always just tightened the bolts down on the plate there and set the transmission up in them, and it's good to go. Got the adjustment right there to tilt it front and back. And the adjustment right there to tilt it side to side. Makes it so much easier putting it in the vehicle with that. Still kind of hot out here too, so this is going to be kind of nasty. I'll show you real quick what I got going on here. Alright. There's the transmission. That's the torque converter. And that's the hole it's got to go in and fill. Sorry, it's kind of crude, but I waited till too late to come home and get started on this. It's the same transmission and everything that goes in our Astro van, the Tahoe, her Suburban, the exact same one. It's a 4L60E. You GM buffs will know what I'm talking about. Pretty decent little transmission, but when they go out big. So, now I get the fun of muscling that big bad boy up onto the jack, and then it should be a cakewalk from there. I took that O2 sensor out of the exhaust right there so that we don't do like we did on my wife's Suburban and bust it out. We replaced that one, but I think that's the one that's giving us a problem too. And then everything else should just bolt right up, throw the starter in it, throw the accessories on it, and we're good to go. Oh, and the fuel lines. Some genius decided to take those all out for me too. Right there's where they're terminated. Anyway, gotta find those and get them reinstalled too, but that's what I'm up to with the 97 now. Didn't forget the project, just haven't had a whole lot of time to dedicate to it lately. Work's been kind of hectic, my sleep schedule's been all screwed up. But, oh, and I don't need the motor mount or the transmission mount. I forgot to tell the one fellow I was talking to about that I did actually find it on the transmission. So we're good to go on that. Thanks anyway. Well, that's all. Be sure to rate, comment, subscribe. I'd appreciate it. And have a good one.